जय हिंद, भारत माता की जय। दोस्तों, नेवे से डाई शो का नया एपिसोड और मैं मेजर डीपी सिंह एक बार फिर से हाजिर है। इन 2020 मेनी ऑफ अस सॉ फेलियर्स ऑफ आर प्लान्स, और कुछ लोगों को तो मैंने ये भी कहते हुए सुना है कि 2020 को डिलीट मार देना चाहिए। बट यू नो व्हाट, लाइफ इज वेरी रिलेटिव। टिल यू सी समबडी एल्स हु इज इन मच वर्स कंडीशन देन यू, यू डोंट फील दैट हाउ मच ब्लेसिंग्स यू आर कैरिंग विद यू। मेजर विक्रम, हु सॉ मेनी फेलियर्स, मेनी अपसेट्स इन फिजिकल एंड इमोशनल अरीना फॉर अ लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन, बट स्टिल विद हिज नेवर से डाई एटीट्यूड टूडे ही इज शाइनिंग विद सक्सेस। हाउ डिड ही अचीव दैट सक्सेस? लेट्स टॉक टू हिम। मेजर विक्रम, वेलकम टू द शो।
Thank you, sir, and a pleasure and honor to be with you on this show. Thanks for hosting me.
Major Vikram, you suffered some injuries in the army, and you know that army actually takes care of the battle casualties, but still you chose to step out of that comfort zone. What were those injuries and why did you step out?
I was in the armored corps, which is tanks, and then I went into Rashtra Rifles, which is infantry, and I was leading an ambush with my men. And in one such ambush, I suffered an injury. It was a severe back injury, and I was hospitalized and all. Given the disability, there was always a provision that my promotions would have still continued. I would have got good postings. The army would have taken care of my medical, everything, and I would have continued to be with the army as long as I wanted to. Then why did I leave? To give an analogy, I was like an opening bowler and a batsman. अब चोट लग गई तो ग्राउंड पे जा नहीं सकते हैं।
सही बात है।
ऑप्शन है कि आप रहोगे टीम में बट यू वॉन्ट बी ऑन द ग्राउंड। नाउ दैट वॉज समथिंग विच वॉज नॉट कंफर्टेबल विद मी। आई वॉज नॉट अट्यून टू द आइडिया ऑफ आर्मचेयर ऑफिसर। सो आई थॉट वुड इट रियली चैलेंज मी, वुड इट रियली एक्साइट मी इफ आई एम नॉट डूइंग व्हाट आई वांटेड टू डू व्हेन आई जॉइंड द आर्मी, देन वुड इट स्टिल बी द सेम। आई डिड माय मास्टर्स इन बिजनेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड देन आई जॉइंड द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड।
It takes courage actually to step out of a comfort zone and choose an arena which is unknown to you. But before that, you were hospitalized also for long. What was the first reaction? What did doctor tell you? तो आपका क्या
जी,
रिएक्शन था?
द डॉक्टर सेड द फ्यूचर इज अनसर्टन, फिजिकल एक्टिविटी विच इज एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ द आर्मी इज रूल्ड आउट। सो इट वॉज रियली द एंड ऑफ अ ड्रीम दैट आई हैड राइट फ्रॉम चाइल्डहुड, टू बी इन यूनिफॉर्म एंड टू कंटिन्यू टू बी डॉनिंग द ऑलिव ग्रीन्स एज एन ऑफिसर लीडिंग माई मैन एंड वेर एवर द यूनिट वॉन्ट्स मी टू गो। बट देन एज दे से, व्हेन एवरीथिंग इज अगेंस्ट यू, दैट इज द टाइम व्हेन द एयरप्लेन टेक्स ऑफ। द एयरप्लेन टेक्स ऑफ against the wind, and I thought this wind is blowing against me, so I need to take off and I need to do something about it. Then I decided ki what are my options, and I explored different avenues and I saw what was my strength, what was my weakness at that point in time.
You know what, thinking about all this and actually stepping into that arena, it must be quite tough. How did you motivated yourself, to step into an unknown arena with a back breaking disability which you were carrying along?
I think that growth happens at the end of the comfort zone.
Exactly.
Nothing grows in the comfort zone, right? So I had an option to be in the comfort zone, continue to lead a cushy life. But then diamonds are formed when they're under pressure. It was really frightening. It was scary because I hadn't seen a single day of civilian life. Kabhi kisi civilian office mein kadam nahi rakha. So the idea of starting off completely new, and finally managed to crack the examinations to enter into a business school and chart my new way in a different career altogether, which I had never thought I would be in. And I was completely apprehensive about it. But then life showed me a path and I just followed like that.
Do you feel army helped you to make up this attitude of yours?
Thanks to the background that I've had as an outcome of being an army child, since my father was in the forces, and then subsequently having trained at the National Defense Academy for 3 years and 1 year at the Indian Military Academy and subsequently serving. Because what they teach you is something which allows you to flourish, succeed in any field. It's not about being the fastest, being the strongest physically, or being the most intelligent. It's about how persistent you are,
Absolutely.
how tenacious you are, what's your willpower. एंड वही जब आपको बोलता है कि 5 किलोमीटर दोबारा भाग के आओ और सब थक गए हो, तब बैठ के आप एक बुक रिव्यू लिखो। सो दे आर टेस्टिंग योर फिजिकल कैपेबिलिटी, दे आर टेस्टिंग योर इंटेलेक्ट, and they're testing your persistence.
If I am not wrong, that year 2008, वो साल भी जैसे ये प्रेजेंट सिचुएशन है वैसे रिसेशन से इफेक्टेड था. सो वो रिसेशन ने आपके सेकंड करियर को कहीं पे चूज करने में इंपैक्ट किया?
This was when Lehman Brothers had collapsed in the US, Merrill Lynch and the other big players on the Wall Street were going bankrupt. So the whole world was in a crisis and jobs were not there. The economy was in double dip recession. So it was a tough time and the prospects were very grim. But as they say, if you have the tenacity, if you have the willpower to still pursue, persist and not give up, you will crack something. And I saw some opportunities in this grim environment and I worked against getting them. But it was challenging to your question. But fortunately, as luck would have it, it worked in my favor. I got a placement from business school, went abroad, did an internship in France with a manufacturing firm based out of there. So things came back on track eventually.
Generally, people get confused when they see such golden opportunities coming to their way, especially from a foreign arena. And vis-a-vis, there is a personal duty. What made you choose the personal responsibility over your career?
I had a personal kind of a loss wherein my father was diagnosed with cancer. And since I'm the only son, my sister was abroad in the US. I felt that it was, of course, I wanted to as well to be with him at that point in time. And I chose to forego those international assignments at that point in time. And I'm happy that I was able to spend time with my father and be with him whenever it was required from a hospitalization standpoint, from a therapy standpoint, and just to be with him at that point in time. What one has to see is what are your priorities in life, right? And everybody is free to decide their own priorities. Nobody is wrong. He had been a source of inspiration, my hero throughout my life. And I eventually got what was destined for me even later in life once things became fine. So in retrospect, what I decided to do was something which I still would want to do. And given any other option, I would still want to relive the same moment again with my father.
But did you really feel ever, other than this incident, ever otherwise also, did you ever regretted your choices which you made in your life?
Steve Jobs said it in his famous speech, which is joining the dots. Everything falls in place because whatever happens in life is for a reason. So I really feel that there is no regret when you look back, because even if it was a failure, it taught you something. If it was a success, it brought you pleasure. It brought you joy. So it gave you something which was positive. It helped you grow as a human being. So really, even if it was bad, it wasn't regretful. It was something which is worth living still.
Each one of us see many failures in our lives. I want to ask, how do you react to any failure?
When you succeed, you are happy, you relate it, and you don't think about it much and you enjoy more of the celebratory mood, right? But when it's failure, it gives you a time to retrospect, to think, to evaluate, and to improve in whatever field that you were lacking in. And of course, I won't say that it's all good. It, of course, gives you a lot of regret. You feel sorry. You feel sad that why did I fail? But that's transition. That's a transient feeling. That's momentary. Okay. After the point, I go into a phase where I try and evaluate it and I try and improve myself.
And what was your most cherishing moment?
When somebody tells you, you know, a medical professional tells you, you won't be able to walk or you won't be able to run again. The day you start running, and you know this more than anybody else in the world, sir, that moment when you start running for the first time in your life, when after being told to it by a doctor that you won't be able to do that, is the most cherishing moment, right?
The injury which you have, uske saath na ek bada irritating pain is connected with that injury. But still you are able to keep yourself fit. How did you manage that?
The injury is not in 100% of your body as I see it. It's affecting 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, but still there's 20% of your body which is fit. So what I did was I kept moving that 20%, right? So as an example, if I have a leg injury, my hands are still fine. I can go on my crutches to the gym and I can still do bicep curls. And the moment you start regaining fitness, the moment your injury starts to get better, the moment your pain starts to reduce, you start challenging your body a little more. And the body responds, right? And eventually I was selected to be the brand ambassador for a campaign which was being done by a food brand which is called Sugar Free. So I became the ambassador for their Get in Shape campaign, and I managed to complete a few half marathons both in Delhi and London, where I was based later.
You know, for a longer period, you saw a lot of injuries and setbacks, emotional setbacks. But overall, now, after undergoing all this, where do you feel you are standing?
Whatever challenge life brings at you, it improves you. So be it a pandemic, be it a recession, be it a depression, be it a physical injury, any challenge which comes to your life, it improves you as a human being, because you come out of it stronger if you've been able to overcome it.
So my final question to you, sir, is that what is your definition of success?
Being successful is about how many people you've been able to elevate to the next level, how many lives you've been able to touch, to reform, to motivate. And it could be in whatever capacity, not monetarily, not emotionally, not professionally, but whatever capacity one has been able to do, if you've been able to transform, elevate another human being on this planet, you've been a successful man. And I look at you, sir, by your actions, by your sheer grit, determination, you've been able to influence and motivate so many of us. So you're a successful man, and that's something which I aspire to be.
Wonderful, Major Vikram. Great talking to you. So you see, people, life is very relative. जब आप किसी दूसरे की कंडीशन को देखते हो तो आपको लगता है कि यार हाउ ब्लेसफुल यू आर. सो काउंट योर ब्लेसिंग्स, स्टे फोकस्ड ऑन योर गोल्स एंड वर्क हार्ड विद परसिस्टेंस एंड ग्रिट. और नेवर से डाई को देखते रहिए, बिकॉज होप एंड पॉजिटिविटी वी एंश्योर हियर. सो टिल वी मीट नेक्स्ट टाइम, टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ. जय हिंद, गॉड ब्लेस यू.
थैंक यू सर. जय हिंद.